there is the famous workbench. Look what I've been doing over here. What is this? I hear you say. This is a frame I've put together out of a few pieces of wood I bought at a well-known DIY store. I think the size of these bits of wood is 1.5 inches by 2.5 inches. And just to make sure the whole thing is level, we've got some nice big adjustable feet there, which I've screwed to the bottom. What's going on? I've had an idea that I would like to build a very simple scenic railway. And I'm going to call it S-Bay because it's nearly as far as T-Bay. Just have to think about that one for a minute, maybe. And I think the idea of the plan is I'll just have two lines running in some countryside, and it's going to be all scenery, because Northway is a lot of railway, a lot of lines, and the scenery takes a secondary consideration, really. It's all about running the trains. This corner here is going to be a nice scene, I hope. First thing I did, I went to B&Q and got a piece of 5mm plywood measuring 4 foot by 8 foot, which in centimetres is 122 by 244. 4 foot by 8 foot. And then I asked a very kind man to cut it into 10 centimetre strips on his very big machine, which he very kindly did. Why did I do that? Now a bit more cutting. Two strips there of equal length of a desired measurement. And some of these blocks, 10 centimetres long. Okay, have you got the picture of the puzzle yet? One there. One there. One there. Like that. Now, some glue. So I'm going to put a dab of glue on there, and there, and there. And then I'm going to put this piece on top. Now, just for a bit of extra security, let's just make sure the top there is level with the bottom. Doesn't actually matter if that sticks out a bit, as long as the top's all level, which it is. Alrighty. Here we see one assembled. Now you've got the idea of what these pieces are for. It's to keep the top board straight. Well, it's all here in the Model Railway magazine. Number 122, September 2008. Baseboard building. And I've done exactly as recommended there. This is to give it strength and to keep it light. Stage one is complete. Stage one of S-Bay. And look, Tommy Walsh would be proud of me. Nice and level. in both directions. Nice and level and flat. Which this piece of wood was not when I bought it in the shop. Little bit warped in places, but these edges straighten it up nicely. Good idea, Model Rail Magazine. Well done. So this is kind of roughly my plan. Of course, it's going to have to be on two levels, knowing me. But not much point work. There's too much point work, in my opinion, on Northway. So here, there's going to be... Well, you might have noticed I've nicely got this so that it will sit just above this table. So right down behind the computer there, I can have a track. There's actually going to be two tracks here and two tracks above. And I'm not going to have such a sharp bend. A more gentle bend, a gentle scenic bend. And where those books are there, I might just put some kind of a viaduct or something like that. And then some hills. Underneath at the back, that won't be visible. That will be underneath the hills. And then let's have a back scene there with lots of lakeland type fells. And this is going to come round here. Yeah, this will be two tracks all the way along. And so will that. That will be two tracks. And I'll be able to have a bit of a fiddle yard under there, depending on how things go. And at the front here, some lakeland type scenery. One idea I've had deep down is the Fala road system. I've seen these at model railway shows with the little cars going round. This is also an idea that's in my head. So the track comes around here. So I've got two tracks there. Now, the difficult bit. The board can sit on top of this chest of drawers here. And the track is coming along the back of the computer onto the workbench. It can come round that corner. Then when it gets to here, there's another chest of drawers there. It's got to get from the chest of drawers to the other chest of drawers. And I feel a bit like Isambard Kingdom Brunel here, or George Stevenson. I have to build a bridge or something that's going to go from there to there. And it's got to be removable, not foldable, not like a drawbridge, but removable. So that most of the time it can just look like that and go in and out of the room and stuff. But then when I want to run the trains, I install the bridge and they can run across there. Now, the bridge will have four lines on it, because there'll be these two lines here, which are in a decline, which I have to get back to ground zero over here. The other ones will be in the decline from this end, going down across the bridge and joining onto there. There will be two lines going round the back. So, it's an engineering challenge, isn't it?
Well, just to put it in perspective, here's Kendall, here's Oxenholm, and we can see the West Coast Main Line going along here. There's the M6, the blue bit, the blue road. And the railway goes along here. Here is the River Lune. Dilly car.
Common. Dilly car, common. You quite often see photographs in magazines of the railway going through Dilly car along the Loon Valley. Well, you go a bit further up. You are in Teabay. Teabay is probably best known these days for being very nice M6 motorway services. But it used to be a bit of a railway centre because it's the beginning of the climb up Shap and they had banking engines there. So Dilly car is just before you get to Teabay. So that's why I've called it S Bay, but it's not Dilly car really, it's a fictitious place just before you get to Teabay. But it's those photographs which I've seen in the magazines in this area that have inspired me to come up with this idea. So there you go. Watch out for part 2.